Let us now study about nuclear fusion somewhat in more details. Let's have a look on the picture which we already seen in the previous section, which gives us the idea about the variation of binding energy with mass number. In this graph, we already seen that middle weight elements which are in the mass number range from 40 to 60, 65 are more stable compared to other elements in nature. So here let us consider a reaction in which nuclei X 150 splits into two nuclei Y and Z, where Y is 60 and Z is 90. And obviously, as X is relatively heavy element, it is X, it splits into two nuclei, one is Y and other is Z. The Y 60 and Z 90, X was 150. So when this X splits into Y and Z, here we can see the binding energies of Y and Z are more compared to that of X per nucleon. That's why we can say Y and Z are more stable. So binding energy per nucleon for X is EX, that of Z is EZ, and that of Y is EY respectively. And in this situation, certainly some amount of energy will be released in this reaction. Now, in this reaction, we can calculate the amount of energy directly by using the binding energy per nucleons. Like, if we talk about the nucleus X, there are 150 nucleons in it. And when the X will split into all its nucleons, it will require total amount of energy which is equals to 150 EX. If we just write down energy required to split X into its nucleons, this can be written as say U1, and that will be equals to 150 EX, because EX is the binding energy per nucleon for the element X. And when all these nucleons combine to produce nucleus Y and nucleus Z, then we can write the energy released when Y and Z are produced. This can be written as U2. When Y is produced, it will release total amount of energy 60 EY, and at the time of production of Z, energy release will be 90 EZ. Actually, these energies we can write as the energies, rest mass energies, which are released at the time of formation of nucleus X, Y and Z. So, in this reaction, if we calculate the total energy released, if this is the reaction 1, we can write total energy released in reaction 1 is this delta E. We can write U2 minus U1, because U1 can be considered as activation energy to initiate the reaction. So, in this situation, total energy release will be 60 EY plus 90 EZ minus 150 EX. This is the energy which we can call as fission energy, which is released in the reaction. Or we can call it also the Q value of this nuclear reaction. And the same energy can also be calculated by using the mass defect, which can be calculated as this energy can also be calculated as, this can be written as delta E is equals to, that will be mx minus my minus mz multiplied by c square. If the masses are given in atomic mass units, this can be directly multiplied by 931.5 MeV. So, this energy and this energy both will be same if you are available with the binding energy per nucleon of the nuclei taking part in the reaction. You can use this method, and if you know the exact masses of the nuclei taking part in the reaction, you can use the method of mass defect to calculate the Q value of the reaction.